of all, I'd like to invite everyone on the first plenary session of the third international conference on soil reproductive medicine. So the theme of the first session is glimpse into the three great medical systems of Asia. And first I'd like to tell you briefly that there's a slight change in the program. So today we'll be having four speakers on this first plenary session. So there's a slight change, and then each speaker will get 20 minutes to speak. So at the end of the 15 minutes, then I'll just make a small sign. So then you could please kindly wrap up the speech within 20 minutes. And then at the end, we'll be having 40 minutes for question and answers from the audience. So first, I'd like to invite Dr. Shivji Guptaji to talk on the topic of Ayurveda, knowledge from home to hospital. So Dr. Shivji Guptaji is the professor in the Department of Shalya Tantra, which is the surgical department of Ayurveda, in the faculty of Ayurveda, Banaras Hindu University. So professor, please start.
A very good morning to all of you. First of all, I bow my head in front of the Lord Dhanvantri. I am from the surgical discipline, and he is the god of the every medicine. Before I am going to start my lecture, first of all, I saw some glimpses of the Banaras Hindu University. In front of the Banaras Hindu University, the statue of the Pandit Madan Mohan Waliyaji, who was the founder of this university. His basic idea, what about, is that, what about our traditional knowledge? It never will flourish without the incorporation of the present science and technology. So keeping this fact in mind, he had established this university, and the first faculty is the Ayurveda College. Now it is under the umbrella of the Institute of the Medical Sciences as a one faculty in this institution. And his views 100 years back, when the India is at almost the orthodox type of the phenomena. At that time, such type of the thinking, our knowledge, our traditional knowledge, will be incorporated with the present science and technology. Then we can propagate to the world, and the world will be accepted these things. Now, I am very much thankful to the organizers for giving me an opportunity in third international conference of the Swarapam, that there is a Tibetan medicine. It is nothing different from the Ayurvedic concept, only there is the nomenclature is changed, but the fundamental principle, whatever the Ayurveda, I think it is almost same in Swarikpa or Tibetan medicine. I am thankful very much to the organizing committee, who has given me an opportunity to interact the August gathering on the occasion of the third international conference. Whatever the topic assigned to me by the organizer is the Ayurvedic knowledge, the knowledge of the Ayurveda is from home to the hospital. It is believed even in advanced era, the Ayurveda is in our household or in the premises of our house. Everything, what we eat, what we drink, it is all derived from, or it is in the form of the Ayurveda, but the people doesn't know that these things comes from the Ayurveda. But in some specific condition, we need the hospital set up for the treatment and propagation of the system. As per definition of the Ayurveda, it is derived the two word Ayu and Veda. The Ayu means the life, and Veda is the knowledge. As by my short knowledge, your Rigpa is also denoted as the knowledge, and Swa is the for the medicine for the reason. So rather than a system of the medicine, Ayurveda, it is a way of life. The Ayurveda believes in a close relationship between the mind and universe, and flow a cosmic energy in the different forms between the living and non-living things. This is the fundamental principles of the Ayurveda. What about the objectives of the Ayurveda? We all know the two objectives, swasthasya swastha rakshanam and aturasya vikara prashmanam cha. The Ayurvedic system focuses on the curing of the illness. This is the aim, but it is not the ultimate. As well as he also believe in the prevention and promotion of the health in healthy individual. With these two objects, the Ayurveda run. To live a graceful and harmoniously in balance of the mind, body, mind and spirit also. So Ayurveda not only limited to the body, but also mind and spirit of the individual. This is all these things balanced, then we can say the person becomes healthy. The another concept which is described in Ayurveda is the Prakriti. This is the psychosomatic constitution of the body. It is described, it is a unique concept of the Prakriti. The Prakriti means it is a genetically determined categorizing the population into a several subgroups based on the phenotypic characters like appearance, temperaments and habits of the individual. Nowadays, the world also accepts this concept ki even though we look in the same, our physiology, our biochemistry, our anatomy is same, but something is different to every individual, and this is the genotype. So the medicine, whatever we prescribe, and the diet, whatever we take, it depends on our Prakriti, and if we not care about the individual, maybe suffer from the disease, and also it is very difficult to planning of the treatment if we not care about the Prakriti. I'm giving in the some details in the next slide. The body constitution, the constitution or body mind typology is an important concept in Ayurveda. Every individual has different physical, physiological and psychological function. The importance of Prakriti or the constitution of the body is it is for the maintenance of the health. We take diet and regime and whatever the environment where we live, it depends on if we try to make a healthy person, we will follow the concept of the Prakriti animal. It also helps to the prevention of the disease, achieving the longevity or long age, and also to consider about the different modalities of the treatment and different constitution of the drug according to the Prakriti assessment. The formation of the constitution or the body Prakriti at the time of the union of the sperm and ovum, predominance of the five elements, that is the Panch Bhautik Tattva, decides the constitution or Prakriti of every individual. Once this proportion is set, generally it remains permanent for the lifetime of that individual. Whatever the Prakriti at the time of the birth, it is persist at the end of the life. The factors which are responsible for the formation of the Prakriti, it depend on the nature of the sperm and ovum at the time of the conception in the fetus, nature of the condition inside the uterus, the food and other regimes adopted by the mother during the time of the pregnancy, and Lastly, I not raised the five elements. I'm already told about the panch bhautik tattva. So the prakriti, the concept is claimed to be useful in the predicting an individual's susceptibility to a particular disease. The prognosis is that illness and selection of the therapy also vary according to the prakriti of the or constitution of the individual. There is types as per there is predominance of the biostatic energies in each individual. Each type requires substance difference or opposite to the constitution to the maintain health. For example, if a Vata type people possess qualities of, it has the qualities of the coldness, dryness and lightness. This is the quality of the Vata. Hence, these person required the food against the characteristic feature of the Vata, like the food is maybe the warm and oily in nature that pacify their own constitutional Vata condition. Otherwise, if they take similar type of the things as a food or behavior, there may be always tendency to the elevation of the Vata and might be in future he might be suffering from the some vatic disorders. So it is important for the consideration of this thing. Now the tolerance of food, drink, environment and even the benefits of the treatment depends on the types of the constitution or prakriti. By understanding the constitution of the individual, one can choose the appropriate food, drink and environment. Hence the maintenance of the health, whatever our health, is every individual should know his own body constitution or own body prakriti. This is the individual uniqueness and this is the genomic or genotypes. We all know Ayurveda is a science of life and it is a common pull to health keeping knowledge shared unrestricted through the passing generation. Now traditionally what happened? Ayurveda is found to have a strong footing in the Indian household. For simplicity and its application and easy access to its modalities being largely derived from the resources searchable easily within the premises of a common home. In our common home, what we use as a food material, what you have or what about our daily routine, it's all these things based on the fundamental principles of the Ayurveda. But majority of the people does not know that we follow the Ayurvedic concepts. The Ayurvedic health keeping principles are more deeply ingrained in the Indian psyche. This influences the Ayurveda is so deep in Indian lifestyle that often many routine acts which are known for their health benefits are ritually followed without noticing that these have a bearing of Ayurveda. This is the a gap in between the person and a system. The wing the derived largely from the natural sources like herbs, condiments and minerals which already have a comfortable positioning in our kitchen, especially in Indian kitchen or you can traditionally. The Ayurveda often being used as a primary care intervention in almost every element unless a specialized care is warranted in certain condition. Generally, we maintain our health by our normal routine diet, the knowledge whatever we have in our house, in our kitchen, in our routine jisko bolte hain dincharya. But it doesn't mean if there is any derangement then the person becomes sick or ill, at that time he need a specialized type of the regime or treatment. It is not we well taken in the household, it needs the some sort of the hospitalization or the hospital care. So Ayurveda home-based application for the health keeping is more profound comparing to the benefits obtained by the Ayurveda when one is sick. And this not worthy to observe that the health care ritually observed in Indian household are actually the assimilated forms of the Ayurvedic fundamentals, which have been refined and simplified by the everyone's use in routine through past few centuries. It is very difficult to speak by the sitting. I am trying to speak loudly. You can get my voice in the last bench? Okay. Actually, it is difficult to speak by the sitting. We are the teacher, so we always teach in a standing position. This is our routine. So, with the rapid advances in the medical science in past few decades, the hospital-based healthcare has grown exponentially. The hospital-based care is marked with specialized care, often requiring a composite monitoring by the dedicated healthcare team, and the formulation like Ayurvedic formulation and other things, which are the fast and dependable. This also requires a thorough investigation pre-therapy and during course of the therapy and maybe after the post-therapy. We assess with the help of the some investigatory tools, facilities, and close monitoring of the patient warrant any, if there is any undisaster or undesired effect of the medicine happen, we can manage accordingly in the hospital. It is never be taken at the level of the house. So by the large, this belief that Ayurveda, although having a good say of chronic and degenerative disorders, may not have a good scope for the acute ailment, where the modern healthcare seems more equipped and hence appropriate. This is the common belief. Ki the Ayurveda is, or whatever the traditional medicine, it is only beneficial for the chronic ailment and some degenerative disorder, but it is not true. Because this belief, hospital-based care remained neglected in Ayurveda and remained strictly limited to the some specific treatment of the Ayurveda like panchakarma and the charso therapy. And till date, nothing has seriously been done for the rectify this image by so causing that Ayurveda may also be effective as a hospital-based care. The role of Ayurveda in emergency treatment. I'm already told this is the common perception of the people. The Ayurveda is the for only for the chronic ailment and some degenerative disorder. But the question arises or arose whether there was a no emergency in ancient time and the people were suffering only from chronic ailment. The answer to this question is no. And the people were well managed in life-threatening condition too at that time also. There is a documentation of the literature of Dharun and Ashukari like emergency diseases, which is implies that the emergency was well managed by using the Ayurvedic medicine. Here, I'm not taking much more time. The some description of the acute condition, either it is medical or surgical or gynecological or medico-legal emergency, not only described in Ayurvedic literature, but well managed by the Ayurvedic medicine. But this emergency condition is not be taken only up to the home level. There is need of the some specialized care, and there is need of the hospital care also. So we have, however, observed that Ayurveda is found equally effective in many acute and intractable illness where the conventional care does not respond. So there is need of the today to find out the some thirst area where Ayurveda can get better result. And whatever the things, if we try to establish as a globally, there is need of the evidence-based research in Ayurveda also or any other traditional medicine. And by the research, there is need of the publication and reported journal. And if there is not a bulk of the patient or a group of the patient. If there is only one patient responded by your therapy, it may be published as a case report in the reported journal. So the hospital-based care in Ayurveda is a need of a comprehensive team of the competent physician and surgeons and some specialists like Charsutra specialist, Panchkarma specialist, and the other some specialists. Then we can also, there is need of the some specific dietitian, especially whatever the things are routinely mentioned in the Ayurvedic literature, the specific nursing personals who are equipped with the knowledge of the Ayurvedic fundamental principles, the some pharmacist which is based on the not modern pharmacy but Ayurvedic pharmacy also, Panchkarma technician, and along with this, a well-equipped kitchen also for and simultaneously well-equipped pharmacy, then we can achieve the good health and we can popularize our system of the medicine. Apart from that, there may be need of the evidence-based study by different centers. I'm giving here some glimpses of our study, because especially I am a person of the surgical discipline of the Ayurveda. So here I'm quoting not a general medical cases, but I'm giving some example of the surgical cases where there is need of the specific hospital management and a specific hospital tool. I'm giving only 2-3 minutes. I'm giving some examples of the wound, brana, and dosh prana, which is described in Ayurveda. I'm not going in detail to the literature. Susrut, who is the founder of the surgical discipline of the Ayurveda, he had described the several modalities of the treatment, near about 60 types of the treatment of the management. And I'm giving one, a very vigorous infectious disease is the foreigner's disease. It is nothing, it is a necrotizing fasciitis, and the mortality rate of the foreigner's disease as per the world literature near about 30-40%, but in our city, in BHU, Banas Hindu University, we well manage such type of the cases with the help of the fundamental principles of the Ayurveda, but here the routine care, daily care is needed in patient, then in our setup, the mortality rate is less than 5%, while in worldwide, the mortality rate is 30-40%. So I'm giving an example here, a case of the necrotizing fasciitis gangrene. There is a necrotizing fasciitis of the scrotal and the perineum, and this is the day one. Immediately, we debride these things with the help of the mild surgical intervention, and now we manage, see, even though after the fecal contamination of the wound, with the help of the fundamental principles of the Ayurveda, after 18 days, the condition of wound is very good. In modern concept and modern surgery, generally they do in such type of the case, they divert the fecal matter. The diversion of the fecal matter, either by ileostomy or colostomy, then they manage the wound. But we manage the wound in the same natural phenomena, patient passing their stool by the same route, and even though there may be contamination of the fecal matter, the condition of the wound is very good, and it heals like such a nice way, even in routinely. So for such type of the things, there is need of the hospital care. It is not done by only one man, and we can't put the patient in the home. So there is a need of the specialized team to manage such condition. Definitely, we took only the Ayurvedic principles, only the Ayurvedic medicine.
So I'd like to request Dr. Shivji Guptaji to kindly wrap up the session.
Okay. I'm just giving some other pictures. Here, we can prove in our medicine is effective or not with the help of some evidence-based research. So we may therefore give a serious thought to the face lifting of the Ayurveda by giving a chance to act competitively on the front of the hospital-based care. This would possibly given us an opportunity to explore the other best part of the Ayurvedic healthcare potentials, which are still unknown to most of us. And with these words, again, I am very much thankful to the organizer, and sorry for taking 2 minutes late. Thank you very much. If there is any question, you can ask.
So I'd like to thank Professor Dr. Shivji Gupta ji for your talk on the topic on Ayurveda knowledge from home to hospital. So the question and answer session is at the end. So I'd like to request Professor to please be seated.